in the late 90s. Patrick was a student at Pencrest High School, and they devised a way to get sticks modified to put on power wheelchairs so that Pat could play hockey. Upon his graduation from high school in 2003, he formally started Philadelphia PowerPlay.
The other area developed is Pat attended muscular dystrophy camp every summer. That was another area where we were able to attract players and get them interested and became members of the team.
Patrick and Bryce played together for many years, and he and Patrick became great, great friends.
I have been with the Philadelphia PowerPlay for, I believe, going on 15 years. I loved it. From the first time I saw Brian, and I always wanted to be on the team and actually play games, and this was a dream come true.
The Philadelphia Flyers PowerPlay is a great avenue for Bryce to explore. It gives him, as well as many people in power wheelchairs, an outlet to do things that are not readily available to people that are handicapped. It's become a phenomenal family.
It's a wonderful resource for the parents because they finally have something that their disabled child can do. Because of the type of muscular dystrophy that Pat had, which was Duchenne muscular dystrophy, it's a disease that progresses in the muscles. As he got older, the heart being a muscle weakened, and then eventually he had passed away from cardiac arrest.
Pat was very proud of having so many members join the team with all types of disabilities, and it didn't matter what their age was. He just wanted them to have an opportunity to play in a competitive sport and develop friendships to have a good time together.
We had always had a nice relationship with the Flyers. When Pat passed away, they came to us and asked if we would like to become the first team that was affiliated with the National Hockey League team.
I love this power play team. I have more fun than any of the people that are out there, and they never let anything get in the way, which is really important.
The first tournament that we played in was 2009. We just fielded a team, and oh my God, we got smoked.
Michigan was there, Minnesota, and the host team, North Carolina. The game starts, and within a matter of a minute, we're trailing like 4-0. And we say, hey guys, the game started here. And they just didn't realize how competitive it was. The Michigan team really took our team under their wing. And our kids learned to develop skills.
So from that tournament, we learned that this is serious competitive play. And it grew enough and became strong enough with great coaching and a commitment by everybody that we were able to win our first championship.
And then this past summer, we played in Toronto and won the North American tournament again.
It's just a great commitment by everyone in the organization to make something special. When they went to the Nationals, which they won this year, they were the Philadelphia Flyers power play, and that was very important to all of us.
We became aware of the Flyers Warriors team and knew that they were veterans that had some sort of disability, be it physical, PTSD, and it was automatic that this was a fit for us.
The Flyers Warriors team were impressed with how competitive our kids are. And our kids love playing that.
Sports, in this case, brings a group of athletes together that perhaps wouldn't have the opportunity to participate. They compete, they practice at their game, and they want to win.
It's important that we make it as professional as it can be, but today was just wonderful. Nothing better.
You always want to be ready to play. Always want to give it your all. And if you're going to play, you play to win. Every day I think of Patrick, and it's all because of what he started.
I'm Shirley Mann.
And I'm Regina Mitchell. For more videos like this, subscribe to WHYY.